Great. Well, Beth LeClair from the Barrett Hill Farm, located in Mason, joins us right now in the News 9 kitchen. And Beth, this is strawberry season. You said that it's really at its height right now.
It is, yes. This next week is the prime picking, and then it's going to descend from there. But if you know, the weather looks awesome, so get out and pick your strawberries if you can.
And when are you open for pick your own strawberries?
From 8 in the morning until 6 at night.
And of course, if people don't make it to Mason to pick those strawberries, you also bring them to the Manchester Farmers Market.
Yes, we do. On Thursdays from 3 until 6:30, we're at the Manchester Farmers Market. You can find us on Tuesday in Bedford and Wednesday in Merrimack.
So. Okay, and there's the times for it. It's Thursday from 3 to 6:30, yep. And located right next to Victory Park there along Concord Street. So it's a great way to find all of this. I know you brought in some great radishes,
yep.
Strawberries, also the leafy greens here, and also rhubarb.
Yes, rhubarb and cherries are just starting to come into season. We have some nice sweet cherries and some sour cherries. These are fantastic for making cobblers and any kind of pies.
Mm.
Those are awesome.
And everyone loves strawberries. Of course, 4th of July is coming up. Strawberry shortcake,
yes,
is kind of associated with that. What are you making here today?
Well, I decided to do a strawberry sundae. We used Connolly Brothers ice cream from Temple, New Hampshire, and we're mashing up the berries here. And all you have to do, we have these nice little hullers at the farm stand, and you can pull the greens off. If they're not dirty, you just toss them into the bowl. Otherwise, you can rinse them off.
And I've heard that it's best to kind of just dust them off.
Yeah, it is.
Why is that?
Because they don't get all waterlogged and,
yeah,
mushy. They're beautiful in their natural state. So.
Okay, all right.
Yep, just leave them right as they are. And then we mash them up. You can add a little sugar just to taste, just a tiny bit. And then pour it over those. Awesome. And these are so juicy. Look at all that juice.
Looks delicious. Now, the season is really so short. So if people go picking and they come back with a ton of strawberries, what would you recommend that they do with it to make them last maybe all year if they can?
Oh, for sure. I would definitely freeze them, because after they're frozen, you can make jam with them. You can use them to make smoothies. You can do anything. Put them on your, make toppings like this in the winter for your, breakfast, or put them on cereal. They work awesome in oatmeal, any of those things.
But you should definitely take off the greens,
yeah,
first.
Yeah, that's all you have to do, is take off the stems and pop them in the freezer bag.
And they'll last
until next year, so.
Really?
Yep.
That's great.
They
and
last
this looks
really
delicious.
Well. And then we can just dollop a little bit of whipped cream on there.
And there you have it, and a cherry on top.
There we go.
And you're good to go. Thank you so much, Beth.
Right.
And again, don't forget the Manchester Farmers Market. Of course, there are farmers markets going on all over the state, so you can check those out as well. And we'll be right back.